Hello and welcome by AA's Art Channel. My name is Ilkjan Wiersma and today I'd like to talk about this painting that I recently painted. But before I do that, I think it's nice to remind you of the last tutorial that I made, because that's all about how I came up with the concept of this painting. How I drew the dragon, how I adjusted the reference photo that I used for the background, and all that kind of stuff I am talking about in this tutorial. I will have a card pop up, so maybe it's fun to check that first, and then come back to this one, and then I'm gonna show you how I painted this painting on a canvas. And because of the size of this painting, you also see a little bit of my screen next to my easel. And normally I try to avoid it because it doesn't look kind of nice in this tutorials. But I made basically a reference photo, and I had it on that screen, so next to my easel, and from that I drew and painted in my dragon and also the background. So I thought that would be fun to show it for once. So let's start that tutorial now. And as usual, I start out with a base color. And most of the times I'm starting with a mid-toned color, and basically on the dark side, because I like to work from dark to light. So that's what you see me doing now. And I applied, I think, 2 layers of this bluish color, just to get rid of the white of the canvas. And also I try to get it quite smooth. I'm not completely smooth, as you can see. I needed some texture there for the sky, so I left some texture, but I also like to work from on a quite smooth canvas. So I built up texture later on, as you see me doing now with the clouds. And to be honest, I tried different clouds here, so you see me adjusting quite often the clouds, because I wasn't sure which size and which shapes to go with for the clouds. So I just tried some different clouds in the background, and I will come back to that later. Now I'm just painting in the clouds, mountains, quite roughly, just to know where they go, and I can better decide where I wanted to go with the sky and the clouds. So I also, if you saw my other tutorial on the reference photo, I adjusted only the sky quite a bit, because I talked about it with my husband, and he was obviously around quite some times when I was painting, and we came up with some different ideas while I was painting. So therefore you see me adjust quite a bit on the sky. And here I'm using also the airbrush, but I only use it now with, I have filled it with water, so I can keep the paint quite wet for a longer time, because as you may know, the acrylic paint has a tendency to dry quite quickly, and that will give me not the ability to blend in wet into wet. So therefore I like to use the airbrush just for water and spray it on a paint quite often to keep it wet as long as needed. And if you do that, you can keep it wet very long. So therefore the airbrush is also very handy. And I have a double action airbrush, because I also use it with paint, but if you only use it for water, you can use the single action airbrushes, who are quite a lot cheaper than the double action airbrushes. But yeah, I also use it for paint, and you will see me use it later on for the highlights on the sky and to get the star in. I will also use the airbrush for that. But now I'm just building up my texture in the sky, in the clouds, and I'm especially paying attention at the lights and the darks, and also a bit on the color, but I can glaze over color later on, and I also will do that to give it a more feeling of a complete painting. I'm just using, like I said, different lights and darks now to get in those shapes. I'm not that busy with the exact color right away, because I, like I said, I can glaze it on later. And but yeah, I like to stay in the tones of the color, so I'm a bit darker than I will end up, but it's that way it's quite easy to adjust later on. And also I'm painting in with the airbrush, a bit of fog there in the distance, and I like the airbrush for that because it gives you a really smooth and soft feeling, and for clouds and for a fog is that really handy, of course, because you don't want to have harsh lines in that case. And now I drew my dragon over the painting, and I'm just painting over some areas I have been painting in already, and that is because the acrylic dries so quickly, it is harder to paint around the subject. Yeah, and most of the times you will see that in your finished paintings when you paint it around the subject, so therefore I like to fill in the completely background and then paint over it. And here is a little exception for that rule, because I just filled in a bit of sky and I'm just painting over these trees now, and the other section of the painting I just left out because I knew there were be only trees there, so I'm just filling in that now. But when I have a subject like for example in this painting, as the drying flying through the image, I just like I said, paint in the whole background and then come again and draw in my dragon and just building up from there. And I left the dragon for a moment now, and I started on the trees and on the forest, I should say. And that is also because it makes it then easier for me to adjust my values on the dragon later on. So therefore I like to fill in the other spots around the dragon. And also, to be honest, this can be quite time assuming when you fill in those areas. And to be honest, the main subject was the dragon, and just to avoid losing my interest, because that can happen when you're working for quite a long time, well, it can happen to me, that I'm losing my interest for the painting or drawing, I like to fill in the areas around it, because this, what I'm doing now, filling in the dragon and those details on the dragon, is the most fun for me. So I leave that for the last for the painting, so I don't lose my interest. And way of working works very well for me. And I discovered that later on, when I started painting, I didn't notice that. I just had to talk myself through the painting and keep myself motivated to finish the paintings or drawings. But now I sometimes just fill in the spaces I just don't like as much, but who are also very important, of course, to make your painting nice and how you want. So you have to take your time, but this is a little solution for that problem, for me at least. And here once again I'm trying to stay in the tones of the colors, but most of the time the mid-tones, I'm not quite exact with the color, because like I said in when I was painting the sky, I can glaze over my colors quite easily, but I like to start out with almost the exact colors. Maybe most of the times I'm a bit darker than I will end up, and I'm doing that because then the glazes will show up much nicer, I think, and you can see the you don't need as much layers when you were starting with a complete different color. So therefore I like to stay in the hues of the color, but I start out most of the times a bit darker. And on the highlights I do the opposite, to be honest. I'm painting in a bit lighter and glaze over my colors and darken it up. That's just only on the highlights, if that makes sense. But that will come with experience. You can do both ways, but I discovered that I found this a bit easier. And here I'm building up some details, and I'm not very exact with those details, but I just want the feeling of those details there, because it's a very big painting and we will watch that painting as a whole artwork, of course. So basically nobody will be up close close to the painting, that they all see those little lines, but they have to be there to get the indication of his scales. So therefore, I like to paint in those details, those little lines, and then I will glaze over them again, so they will fit in much more. Before the glazes, they look like they are lying on top of the dragon, but if you're using glazes, they will come together as one part, which is very important, of course. And also on that, this blacken has to be a blue with gold. And for the gold, I'm not using the actual gold paint. I have those around, but I never used them before. But for the feeling of the gold, I used yellow agate. And I don't know if I pronounce that good, but I will have a link in the video description. And also some Naples yellow to make those highlights, with also a mixture of titanium white. And I think those three will, I think those three I had for the highlights, and those will give that, lighted feel, and also the gold feel on his body there. And also with the dark blue, I needed those darks there to give it a lighter feel. So you have a bit of an indication of which colors I've used there. And now I'm filling in those last details. I'm using the highlights, and I'm not using the titanium white only, but I mixed in some blue that I also used for the background. And this is a photo of the original artwork. And as usual, it's very hard to get the colors as right as in a painting, but this one was the closest as the original piece. So, and of course, I hope you like this piece. So yes, it was a whole new concept for me, and I really, really liked it. And it took me a lot of more hours, of course, because I had to come up with a reference first of all, and then the actual painting. And because of the size of the painting, it took me quite some time. But that's okay, of course. It's really, really fun to use this, and of course, it took me longer than normal because I had to try a lot of different things on the iPad Pro, because I basically didn't know what I was doing, so I have to test my pencils and also the brushes before I had the actual reference good enough to start my painting, because the reference wasn't as detailed as my painting, but I had enough lines and light and darks to start this painting as I told in the tutorial. But yeah, I really like to make something different than normal. I'd like to try new things out, because I think that will give you a lot of ability to find out new techniques and to learn new things. So try to get out of your comfort zone once in a while, because you will discover really nice things. I had a really fun time to make this painting, because I came up with a lot of new techniques that I can't wait to apply in my other paintings. And it's this time it was a lot about the light and the darks in my paintings, and different colors. I used different mixes of colors than I normally use, and that's really nice. It gets me very inspired for other paintings. So I will come up with another tutorial very soon. So for now, I'd like to thank you for watching, and like I said earlier on, if you have any questions, don't hesitate, leave them in the comment section below. And for now, I'd like to, like I said, thank you for watching, and if you like, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and my own website. If you like this tutorial or my other tutorials, please give it a thumbs up, I would really like that. And of course, if you like, please subscribe to my channel, I would really like that as well. I see it as a compliment for my work, and it's really fun knowing that people are liking your tutorials, especially when you are making those, and also that takes quite some time to get it adjusted in a way you like, and to get used to explaining in the tutorial. So therefore, thank you for supporting my work, and I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye bye.